Hello friends, in this video we are going to understand the concept of statics of random process. I'll suggest you to go through the videos of random variable so that you can understand this video. So far we have discussed about the random process definition and its notation. Now we will look at the representation of the random process and how the random process is defined. To look at the mathematical description of the random process, or we can say that statistical approach of the random process, we need the probability description of the random process. To understand the probability description of the random process, it is very important to first understand the concept of random variable, because random variable is the key point, or we can say that base point for the random process. So let us look at the random variables approaches for the statics. The probability description of the random variable is such that it consists of two functions. One is called as distribution function, or I should say that probability distribution function, and second one is density function. Random variable, they are defined with the help of probability description, and when we are talking about the distribution function, such that it is represented by fx of x, then this is equivalent to probability x less than or equals to x1. For a discrete random variable case, for a continuous random variable case, they will be different. But the base point is that whenever I am talking about the distribution function, this capital X is less than or equals to x1. Similarly, when I am talking about the density function, if CDF is known to us, I can say that density function is fx of x. It is nothing but the differentiation of this fx of x. This is the density function and this is the distribution function or probability distribution function, that capital X random variable is less than x1. Now, as we defined the random process with the help of random variable, so we will try to go towards the same approach as we used this distribution function and density function. We will try to define the random process in the same manner by first considering the random process as random variable. Then we will define the probability distribution function and density function. First of all, look at this equation fx of x1 comma t1. As we discussed in our previous video, that every random process is defined like this. This one, if it is consist of x of lambda, if I am saying that random process is this one and I am fixing this lambda I here, this one. So what I am doing, that first of all I am fixing this value t1, this one. If I'll use this I as a variable, as a subscript, such that I can be equals to 1, 2 or 3. So by fixing this time, then this particular random process is equivalent to random variable x of lambda. As we discussed in our previous video, that for a particular time, we can say that that point is nothing but this point is nothing but random variable. So here we have a distribution function fx of x1 comma t1, because this x1 is nothing but, let's say this is a random process and I'm at particular time t is equals to t1, I'm taking this numerical value. Let's say this is x1 of t1. This x1 of t1 is nothing but a random variable. So when I want to look at the distribution of this random variable, I can say that it is equivalent to fx of x1 comma t1, as this is also defining on the time axis. That's why I'm considering that x1, when t is equals to t1, then the distribution can be defined something like this, x of t1. It means that it is a random variable capital X at point t is equals to t1 is less than or equals to x1. This is how we can approach for the random process with the help of random variable. This is called as first order distribution. How we can define the first order distribution? That at particular time t is equals to t1, we have a numerical value which is x1. When probability of x of t1, it means that random variable at t1 is less than or equals to x1, whatever numerical value it is taking, when it is less than x1, such a distribution is known as first order distribution. So what we can say that if for a random process x of t, it means that we are already fixing the value of outcome, that for a particular outcome we have a random process x of t. By looking at that random process, at t equals to t1 we have a numerical value x1, and probability of x of t1 is less than or equals to x1, such a distribution is called as first order distribution of x of t. If I want to calculate the density function, then density function can be find out with the help of the differentiation of this distribution function. So let me represent it by fx of x1 comma t1. This small f is representing us the density function, and it is equivalent to differentiation of this distribution function. So this is how we can define the distribution function, density function, for the first order, that is for a particular single value of numerical value of random process. This is a first, this whole discussion was based on a single random variable. Now I'm looking at two different points for us. This is the x of t, this is our random process. We are analyzing this random process. At particular time t1, this is x1 t1. Let's say at particular time t2, it is equals to that numerical value is equals to x of t2. This is small one, x2 of t2. So we have now two random variable, x1 of t1, x2 of t2. So what I can say that now we are considering the case of multiple random variable, and for the multiple random variable we have a joint distribution function, we have joint density function. This is what we discussed in the case of multiple random variable, that for a case of more than one random variable we have a joint distribution function, we have joint density function. So for a given t1, again for a t1, we have x of t1 is equals to x1, and x of t2 at t equals to t2, x of t2 is a x2. They are nothing but a random variable. They represent two random variable. Now the joint distribution is called as second order distribution. Why it is called as second order distribution? Because we are defining two random variable at time t1 and t2. That's why this joint distribution is called as second order distribution. Now let me represent it by like this, fx of x1, x2, when they are taking the value at t1 and t2. This is how we always go for this kind of notation. Then it is equivalent to probability. Now we have a random process x of t, but we are looking this random process as two different time. So x of t1 is less than or equals to x1. Similarly, x of t2 is less than or equals to x2. This is how we can represent for second order distribution. Similarly, if I want to calculate the density function, I'll differentiate this second order distribution. Now this is the representation, a small fx at x1, x2, t1, t2 is equals to del square, because it consists of two variables, so I'll differentiate it at two times. So del square del x1, x2, fx, x1, x2, t1, t2. Now let me take T3 at point T3 at point T4, or I can say, I can take it at like Tn values. I can define this random process for all the numericals value for Tn times. At T1, I am getting x1 T1 random variable. At T2, I am getting x2 T2 random variable. Because every time, whenever I am fixing the time, I am getting a numerical value. And that particular numerical value is nothing but a random variable. So now we have a n random variable. So for n random variable, I can say that the distribution will be like this: x1, x2, and so on up to xn. Similarly, t1, t2 up to tn. It means that x1 is this. x1 we are getting at t1, x2 we are getting at t2. This is how we always go for this kind of representation for the random process. And this probability will be equals to x of t1 less than or equals to x1, x of t2 less than or equals to x2, and so on up to x of tn less than or equals to xn. This is how we will define the nth order distribution. For random process x of t, just by looking at a single random process which was a function of time, I can define the nth values. If I am interested in calculating the value of density function, then I can say that density function will be equals to, or I should say that nth density function will be equals to small x1, x2 up to xn, t1, t2 up to tn is equals to del nth upon del x1 up to del xn and the whole function, this function. So this is how we can define the nth order distribution and nth order density function. N can take any value, n may be equals to 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So just by the knowledge of this random variable concept, we are able to define the probability description of this random process, which is equivalent to x of t. So it's very important to have the knowledge of random variable, and it will be very easy to understand the random process with the help of random variable. So what we can say that if any random variable, let's say this capital X is a random variable, if I want to look at the random variable with the help of a random process, I can fix the time. If time is fixed for the particular value of lambda, we can say that it is equivalent to x of lambda, and that x of lambda is nothing but random variable. If I am saying that fx of x is the probability density function of continuous random variable, then we can, now I am saying that for a particular time t1, this is how I can represented like this. Now at random variable, we are getting the same random variable, but at particular time t1, then this will be the PDF of random process. So whenever we are adding this time small t factor, this time in the function, that particular function is defined with the help of this small t, whether it is a distribution function or density function. When it is consist of this time, small time t, then it will be known as a random process. So with the help of this concept, I can say that if e of x for a random variable case, minus infinity to plus infinity x fx of x dx. This is the mean of the random variable. And now I'll replace this function with respect to time. Then I can say that this is nothing but mean of random process. This is the mean of random variable, but this is the mean of random process because that PDF is defining for a particular time. Let's say this is t1, this is x1. So this is our mean of the random process. In this way, we can define all the moment for the random process, whether it is a nth moment or second order moment or third order moment or variance of the random process. We can look at all the statistical averages with the help of the concept of random variable. So thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with eKeda and subscribe to eKeda.